I have with me in studio Ty Barnett.
How are you?
All is well. And Ty's back. I interviewed Ty on my TV show, The Fallen State. TV, and you should check it out. Very interesting. He is a comedian, actor, and writer. He appeared on Comedy Central, The Tonight Show with Jay Leno, and has opened for Donna Summers.
Yeah, yeah.
Looking
a couple
for
things
some hot stuff, loving tonight.
All right, there you go. You still got some soul in you. That's what's up.
Welcome back, man.
Thank you, bro.
I'm glad you're here. So I was just telling you, you see the Kunsack in my studio here.
Yeah, I'm.
And you asked that I pick cotton, and I told you yes. I was born on a plantation in Alabama, right outside of Montgomery, under the Jim Crow laws. I grew up under those laws,
right.
And you were stunned.
I was, because if I went by our last interview, it sounded like you did not have any exposure to any negativity of being a black person. That's what it sounded like to me with the defending of everything that's going on in this country. Like, there was not one thing you said that was that white people, racist white, and be very clear, racist white people have ever done. And that's what it sounded like before. So to see this and to see the sign, I was a little stunned. I didn't know you picked cotton. I give you props for coming up out of that, because I was never around that. So I got to give you, I'll give you nothing but credit for coming up out of that.
What, and twice a year, the boys would be taken out of school to plant the crop and then to harvest to bring it in.
Right.
And so what do you imagine that life was like? What do you think was going on back then?
I don't see anything good coming out of it. I see you forcing people, families, kids, women, to do something that they didn't want to do, all for the betterment of someone else, and it basically helped build this country. Like, that's a fact. Like,
where do you get that impression from?
History. This is all historical. This is all stuff you can look up.
Why? So you think?
So who? Wait, let me ask something. Who did you pick cotton for?
Did you
pick cotton for yourself?
No.
Who'd you pick it for?
For the people that owned the plantation.
On the plantation, right?
So, on, yeah.
So did you get a portion? Did you get a portion of the proceeds?
We got paid and everything. Yeah.
No, I'm saying, did you get paid a fair amount for the cotton that you picked and helped building in the industrial complex of all that? Did you get
no,
paid?
No, I did not. I did
you
not.
You did. So
no.
you picked cotton for somebody else.
Right.
Okay. All right.
They were the boss. I was an employee.
Right. Employee?
Yeah. Just like.
We brought a lot of employees over from Africa, yo.
Just like the people who work for me now don't get a portion of the company's money. They get paid for performing a job, but they don't get the portion of the money.
But they can also leave when they want to leave.
And we can leave when we want to leave. And
no, you couldn't.
Yes, you could.
No.
Look.
No. Do not tell me now
the
slaves could leave whenever they wanted to leave.
Why did you say that?
You talking about between the lynchings, getting their feet cut off, between the rapes, the beatings, the slave hunters, all that?
Why do you think that during the time that I was growing up, under the Jim Crow laws, because there was no slavery at that time, why do you think blacks couldn't leave the plantation when they wanted to?
Because they weren't able. You tell me a slave person. Tell me a slave that who said, "Okay, you know what? I'm out of here. I don't feel like being a slave anymore. I'm out."
So when
no, but I'm saying, do they exist? Does any slave exist that said, "You know what? I'm like Harriet Tubman." Let's just say Harriet Tubman for an example, right?
Right.
So Harriet Tubman basically was like, "All right, you guys, let's not use the Underground Railroad. Let's just walk out and go down the freeway." And we're good.
But when I was growing up, there was no slavery. Slavery was over with.
There's always been slavery. What
no,
are you talking about?
That's not true. And if that's true, why is it that... That's amazing that you think that. I didn't know you thought that.
Thought what?
So you think when I was growing up, under the Jim Crow laws, there was still
slavery. Are you saying you specifically
right.
had the right to leave?
Uh-huh.
You specifically
no,
did.
No, any black can
no, no.
leave.
No, no, no. No, no, no.
Then why did every summer... My uncles would leave and go to Florida and visit, or New York, or wherever they wanted to hang out for the summer.
Again, are you telling
and
me?
When my father and mother finished high school, they moved up north to Chicago.
And so are you telling
or
me?
Indiana.
So you're telling me that according to your personal experience and your family, your
and
direct connection.
And everybody around me, everybody I knew.
So again, I just want a yes or no answer. You're telling me that slaves had the right to leave. Just that's a yes or no.
I'm telling you that there
was a yes or no. The slaves have the right to leave.
I'm telling you that maybe when slavery existed, they didn't have a right to leave. Well, no, they didn't when it slavery existed.
So slaves didn't have a right to leave.
There was no slavery when I was born.
Okay, so you're saying you personally had the right to leave, and you just chose to stay.
I'm telling you, black people had the right to leave.
You can't speak for all black folks.
Yes,
you can only speak for Jesse Lee Pearson.
I can speak for all black people under that circumstance.
You cannot.
Because there was no slavery at the time.
And again, so I'm going to ask you again. I'm going to ask you. And when I say slavery, I don't mean like in the sense of how it was back in the 30s and all that stuff. And when we first came here and all that stuff. I'm not talking about when you were shackled and all that stuff. I'm talking about in the sense that when I say it's always been slavery, it's always been some kind of mental stranglehold, period. But no. that's a whole nother conversation.
There's not been a mental stranglehold.
Right. So what do you mean, right?
What I'm asking you is.
You're saying, and again, I just want to be very clear, that slaves did not have the right to just leave. I just want to be clear on that first.
Slaves, there were some slaves that could not leave when they wanted to.
And how did they distinguish the slaves that could leave and the ones that could go to Florida and Chicago and visit their
family? Because when they were doing that, there was no slavery.
Okay, so you're saying during your personal time of picking cotton—
Slavery
so
had.
When did you stop? When was the last piece of cotton you picked?
Oh, I have a better one for you than
that. When was the last piece of cotton you picked?
I graduated from high school.
68?
67. Probably around 65 or so.
Okay. So you stopped picking in 65.
I would say, give or take.
Now, but it's fair to say the people before you, right, and that picked cotton before you, the generations before you, they were forced to pick cotton. And that kind of bag right there.
They were not forced to pick cotton.
They weren't slaves.
They were paid to pick cotton.
How much did they get?
I don't remember.
Anybody on the show, can we do research?
According to how much the cotton weighed. Because I remember that we used to go like really early to the cotton field while the dew was still out. The cotton was still kind of moist. So we can pick some of the wet cotton, make the bag heavier. But why do you have that impression that's not even true?
What's not true?
That when I was growing up, that blacks were enslaved in the South. That's not true at all.
No. Let me be clear. Let me be clear, because I know you got listeners that are ready to jump on that. And they'll be like, oh, my God, I can't believe you said slavery existed in 67. What I mean by that is the mentality of being a slave, the mentality of who's the worker and who's the plantation owner, the mentality of we are better and your job is to pick this cotton for a fraction of what we're going to make off of this and off of your backs. Now, again, if you tell me if you have information out there that I don't know about, please show me any slaves, any black people that were made rich or made equivalent pay. Like, let's say, I'll give you an example. I used to work at a hospital, right? And when I left that hospital, I was making $20 an hour. About $18, $19 an hour. When I left, that's what I was making at the hospital, right? Yeah. So,
this in California?
No, Seattle.
Seattle, okay.
So, I didn't make the money that the doctors made. I didn't make the money that the head of the hospital, the owner of the hospital made. No, but I made enough money to feed myself, my family, and live a comfortable life. Are you telling me that same thing happened for you and other black people? That you made enough money to live and support your family off of picking cotton?
Yeah.